tuition on higher education, the mandate of the chair is to make sure that we have diversity in order to make the country more globally competitive. At alam nyo, nakakatuwang tingnan sapagkat dito sa inyong listahan ng mga miyembro, makikita na talagang there is that necessary diversity to make sure that we have a good cross-sectional component of the kind of graduates that not only Paranaque needs, but the entire country needs. Sapagkat siyempre, yung mga graduate ng eskwelahan nyo, I'm sure you will not disagree, should cater not only to the needs of Paranaque, but to the needs of the entire metropolitan Manila and even the adjacent provinces and even other parts of the country and the entire world. Because now, if we are going to address what are the objectives of our educational system, we should not limit ourselves to our country. And I know, I don't think I'm more qualified than you to talk about this. You are more qualified, you are more aware. You are now addressing the global requirements as far as education is concerned. I'm reminded, for example, of one of my favorite authors, Thomas Friedman. I'm sure si Dr. San Luis has said to some of my favorite books niya, The World is Flat. And Thomas Friedman discussed why countries like India, for example, is succeeding. And he cited the reason. And this is backed up by another author, in the case of Ray Kurzweil, who's also one of the top scientists in the United States. Ang sabi niya, kaya nagsasucceed ang India because India, for example, is producing something like 70,000 CPAs in 1 year, producing about 300,000 engineers and science graduates in 1 year. So, can you imagine that kind of a society? And that's one reason why they're attending not only to their own needs, but they're also exporting the products and their talents and their graduates to the entire world. And that is one of the keys why India is very successful. And that is also one of the reasons why the Philippines is going to become almost as successful as India. Hindi natin kayang pantayan ang India sapagkat napakalaki ng kanilang populasyon, but we are now approximating what they are doing. I will cite one example. I remember the first time I got exposed to the world of BPO, business process outsourcing. This is about 6 years ago. We were just a tiny component of the world BPO program. Ang Diyos ng panahon na yun was India. We were siguro mga number 5 from India. But then 3 years ago, we became number 3. Next to India, third from India. And now, today, the Philippines is second to India as far as the entire BPO is concerned and number 1 as far as call centers are concerned. And that is quite an accomplishment. And you, the schools in Paranaque contribute to our capability to enhance our BPO competitiveness. Sapagkat marami sa mga nasa BPO ngayon, galing din sa inyo. O kaya dumaan sa inyo. Maybe they speak better English because of the kind of education that first elementary, the public school system in high school elementary was able to give to them, and then in college, and in colleges like you. Kaya napakaganda ang ating mga future. But it was not, you know, nung una, pag sinabi ang Pilipinas, naaalala ko kami dalawa ni I'm a little, mga 1 or 2 years older than the mayor, pero halos pareho ang experience po natin sa education. Nag-uusap kami kanina, nung panahon ng mga 50s, 60s, yung St. Andrews was one of the great academies of Metro Manila. Kilalang kilala ang St. Andrews, pero sapagkat dumami ang mga eskwelahan, siyempre, medyo sumikip na yung daigdig kung dating sa mga eskwelahan. Imagine, like him in Paranaque, mahigit 50 kayo. But you know, before the war, the Second World War, and even at the start after the Second World War, the Philippines was one of the premier learning centers of the world, of Asia. May kita mo yan sa mga grandiose names ng mga eskwelahan natin. For example, ano mga pangalang eskwelahan natin? University of the East. Parang kinlay na natin yung buong East. And when we speak of East, that's from India up to Japan, kasama ng Korea, Singapore. What is CERN University? And I remember also when I was studying in UP, there were so many students coming from America, from Thailand, from India, from Pakistan. When I was teaching in the Asian Institute of Management, half of my students were from other countries, including Western countries, but most of them from Indonesia, from Malaysia, from Japan, and from India, coming here to the Philippines. Pero alam nyo, ito siguro ang magandang challenge para sa inyo, no? Nagkaroon ng mga ranking. Unahin natin yung mga ranking sa nga pala, one of the problematic areas as far as the committed education the Senate is concerned, yung area ng mga local college and university, yung tinatawag ng MCU. Problema sa ibang mga, kasi meron mga ibang syudad, siguro they were not very prepared. Ang ginawa lang, nag-establish sila ng all kinds of local college universities, but in the end, they were not able to compete because they did not have the support of the local government. Nagmadali lang, pero hindi nabigyan ang tamang suporta. But in Parañaque, we are not going to see that because we know that with Mayor Jun Bernabe, he is strategizing very correctly how the LGU, the local government of Parañaque, can come into the picture as far as education is concerned. Nauna yung Parañaque School of Parañaque College of Science and Technology, and now I think this is something that we must welcome, the establishment of the first university, state university in Parañaque, and this is the PUP Parañaque campus under the leadership of Mayor Jun Bernabe. I hope hindi kompetensya sa inyo. Hindi naman siguro. But whether it's competing with you, it is good competition. Sapagkat any competition is going to be good for the health of the school family here in Parañaque. Pero ito, tingnan nyo ha. Nagkaroon ng mga ranking ng mga iba-ibang eskwelahan sa buong Pilipinas. At ang ranking na ginamit ay ayon sa resulta ng mga board exams. At ito po yung nakita ng mga pinakahuling mga ranking na binigay nila, no? Ano natin po ito, no? Local rankings. Ang ginamit na basehan ay yung result ng exam ng PRC. At ito yung mga tinuturing ng mga top performing universities. Nagulat ako, akala ko mga top performing university sa Pilipinas ay maybe most likely UP o kaya Ateneo. Pero hindi po. Ang number one over a 5-year period ay yung Xavier University. Tapos sumunod yung University of Philippines, Diliman, Siliman University, number 4, Santo Tomas, Ateneo de Davao sunod, pamantasan ng lungsod ng Maynila, may pumasok ng Maynila, Mapua Institute of Technology, Central Philippine University, St. Louis University, that's in Baguio, MSU, that's in Mindanao, University of San Agustin, I think that's in Iloilo. At ang pangarap ko, sana darating ang araw, isa sa mga university and colleges na membro ng private school.